Hi, I'm Gerry from Gerry's Craft Room, and in this video I'm going to make two cards with the Holly Jolly Fab Scraps collection. And these are the layers I'm going to start with. The base is 14.5 by 14.5 centimeter, and that's about 6 by 6 inch. And then two layers slightly smaller, and then I have my flowers, the mosaic flowers and the complete flowers. And one is going to be simple and the other one totally extravagant. I distress the edges of the paper and I'm going to tape them to the card. And this is going to be the simple card. By the way, I added the products I used in the description box for you. And if you're new here, don't forget to subscribe. And now I shape the flowers. I use the ball tool on the back of the petals, and then I'm going to turn the flower over and push down in the middle. When all the complete flowers are done, I glue them together in pairs. And then I'm going to glue the flowers to the mosaic flowers. I cut the sentiment out of the beer board frame and cut away the bits that are sticking out. And now I'm going to color it with WOW embossing powder. Just one layer will be enough. And now I add the elements to the card. I added foam tape to the top flower so it keeps its shape. Then the card is done. I will add the flower hearts later. Now let's go crazy with the second card. I start with the same papers and flowers, and for the first layer I'm going to distress the edges and do some tearing. Thank you. Behind the dead parts, I will add some red cardstock, just some tape along the V on the back, and then add the pieces of red cardstock. Now first I go on with the flowers. The mosaic flowers can use some glitter. You can't go wrong with glitter, right? I'm going to color four flowers. I will just show you one. I'm going to cut up one of the flowers and I'm going to tuck the parts under the second layer. And I tear a bit here and there to create some space for the petals. By the way, if you feel inspired, I always love to see your make, so don't forget to use hashtag CharisCraftRoom when you share your work on social media. I color the sentiment with embossing powder, just like the one on the first card, then on with the next layer. I add some thread that I wind around my fingers and then fold it. And then I'm going to tape it in place on the back. To create some dimension, I add foam to the back. Now it's time to assemble. I colored three flowers with the fairy tale embossing powder too, and then the snowflakes with the silver. And it's easiest to color the elements you want in the same color at once, of course. I'm shaping the complete flowers with my ball tool, and then I'm going to glue the flowers together. I will add some ink to the sentiment along the edges, and then I'm going to heat set it, and this will give a very subtle color. And now I love this part, bringing all elements together on the card. I would love to hear what's your favorite part, just leave me a comment. I just keep moving the pieces around and cutting them up here and there, and when I'm sure where I want them, I glue them to the card. And now I will add some crystal drops. I also added some crystal drops on the backing of a piece of double-sided film and leave that to dry overnight. And they will make lovely flower hearts. Don't be afraid to use a different color for little accents like this. And once the flower hearts are dry, I add them with a little crystal drops dot as a glue, and I'm going to let that dry. Hi my lovely viewers, so nice of you to stay until the end of this video. Here is the easy card, the simple card with the basic layers, and here is the same card but then in the super extravagant version. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, click the thumbs up, and if you like to share this video, please do. I love for you to share my video. And if you want to subscribe to my channel, please feel free to. I love to have you as a new subscriber here. So I want to thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye!